Okay, so now kita nak tengok pula bargaining happens when property rights belong to the recreational users. So kita reconsider balik, ya, kita tengok semula the property rights yang assigned to the refineries firm itu kita assign pula kepada recreational users. So bila recreational users yang memegang property right, ini bermaksud technically refineries tak boleh produce any quantity of goods. Sebab of course recreational user tak nak benarkan sebab dia nakkan, dia tak mau pollution tu berlaku. That's why kita assume bargaining itu start at Q equals to zero. So when quantity equals to zero, itulah bargaining bermula. Ya, untuk kalau property right ini berada dalam kepada user. Okay, jadi based on the market-based motivation, yeah, to bargain with the recreational user in an attempt to get them to accept payment for their rights to the river, yeah. So maknanya dekat sini refineries firm dia akan bargain untuk get the rights, yeah, to pollute lah, ataupun dia nak produce, maknanya dia nak some kind of kebenaran, ya, kebenaran untuk membuat pollution dah. Sedikit pun jadilah kan, ya, sebabnya dengan production akan menyebabkan pollution, dia tak boleh lari daripada itu, ya. Jadinya dekat sini sama juga condition dia, so refineries ini dia willing to pay, ya, dia buat, dia boleh offer payment, willing to offer payment such that the price is less than the, yeah, marginal private benefit minus marginal private cost, ataupun kita kata the payment less than marginal profit, and then recreational user akan willing to accept the payment if the price is greater than marginal social cost minus marginal private cost, ataupun payment is greater than marginal external cost, yeah, right. Jadinya bargaining itu akan berlaku starting from quantity equals to zero sampailah at the point yang dia akan capai efficient, iaitu quantity E. Okay, so at this quantity E, yeah, kita katakan bahawa marginal private benefit minus marginal private cost are equal to marginal social cost minus marginal private cost. Ataupun kita kata marginal profit is equal to marginal external cost. This is the meaning of this point. Jadi dekat sini lah sama juga. Okay, so they start, yeah, the firm akan start bargain at this point sampai capai this, sampai capai this quantity E. Yeah, kemudian sama juga dia punya, this is the point apabila marginal external cost dan marginal external external cost dan juga marginal profit itu, right? So that is the how this bargaining process is being operated. Okay, now kita nak tengok what are the limitations of this chaos theorem, yeah. So the limitation would be, of course, this theorem looks ataupun nampak powerful, yeah. Sebab when someone get the property rights, then the efficiency can be achieved, yeah, based on the bargaining ataupun negotiation process itulah, yeah. However, the model have the prediction atau assumption kata apa, transaction cost zero dan juga the damage can be accessible and measurable. So this is actually the limitation of the assumption. Ya, maksudnya dekat sini, kalau kita compare secara reality, secara practical, kita tak boleh kata transaction cost itu zero. Ya, sebab satu, dia affect many parties. Dia bukan affect both parties sahaja. Dia affect banyak parties. Yeah. Kemudian, cost untuk bargain itu sendiri adalah banyak. Macam-macam cost. Yeah. Jadi, kita tak boleh kata the cost is actually zero. Macam legal consensus. Yeah. Legal consensus macam kita nak bayar anything lah, macam kita maksudnya kita ada government, then government akan come out dengan tax, kita kena bayar legal, kena bayar permit ke apa ke, macam-macam benda yang kita kena bayar, then itu bukannya zero, cost tu ada. Jadi kita tak boleh assume cost zero. And then difficult to identify the sources of the damage and assigning a value to that damage. Bukan senang kita nak tengok datang mananya damage itu. Adakah betul datang daripada petroleum punya production? Ataupun dia datang daripada tempat lain? Sebab pollution kita tak boleh kata satu tempat saja. Pollution boleh berlaku di mana-mana saja. All around the environment ataupun surrounding kita itulah. Yeah? Jadi kita kata susah kita nak assign the value to that damage. Right? So that's why kita boleh guna common property resources. Yeah. So these common property resources are those for which property rights are shared by some group of individual. Maknanya property right ini kita boleh share by group of individual. Yeah. So with these common property resources, the problem happens juga. Yeah. Public access without any control leads to resources exploitation. Dia akan menyebabkan masalah exploitation of the resources. And generate negative externality juga. Yeah? Alright? Kenapa? Because each co-owner, yeah, dia akan membuat decision about using the resources based on dia punya private cost and benefit. Sebab each and every person, dia ada dia punya benefit dan cost itu sendiri. Suka hati dia nak buat macam mana. Then, bila each and every cost, based on each and every private cost, yeah, private cost and benefit, so dia akan ignore decision that will affect other owner of the property right. Okay, contohnya there is leak, yeah, jadi tasbihlah eh. So each person that actually yang apa ni dekat tasik tu boleh catch fish, betul tak? So each person would fish, yeah, from the lake based on private motivation. So dia akan memancing lah, memancing ikut suka hati tanpa memikirkan tentang population of the fish. Sama ada ini cukup untuk masa akan datang, adakah cukup untuk pembiakan ikan dan sebagainya. Faham tak dekat sini? Jadi dia akan buat mengikut suka hati dia, private benefit and cost. Dan tanpa memikirkan tentang orang lain. Okay. So what will be the solution? Yeah. So government should intervene lah. Yeah, macam saya kata tadi lah. Kenalah assign tax and so on. Jadinya based on what? Based on internalize the externality by the government. Yeah. So force the market participant to absorb the external cost or benefit, right? So how it can be done? Through the assignment of property rights. Maknanya sekarang ni government yang kena assign the property rights lah, right? So government have to make the this determination as well as enforcement limitation on this right for the good of the society. Maksudnya government kena ada limitation, put the limitation berapa sahaja yang boleh peliut, berapa sahaja society, maksudnya kebenaran untuk pencemaran. Dan supaya society ini punya benefit taken care of, right? And then there will be other approaches juga lah ya. Internalize the environmental externalities, yeah, by for example put price, yeah, by the amount of the associated cost or benefit. Kita maksudnya contohnya by imposing tax. Yeah, on the marginal external cost itu kita impose tax. Right? And then recently ada policy dekat US di mana establish market and price for pollution. Right? And then I think Malaysia pun sama juga. Yeah, untuk pollution ini, berapa banyak you nak pollute pencemaran, you have to pay the tax to the government. So that the tax, the pollution ataupun the activity are actually will be controlled by the government, will be monitored by the government lah, supaya environment tu tidak berlaku, supaya environmental tu will be conserved and pollution yang berlaku tu tidak terlalu tinggi. Right? So that is the end of this chapter. I think we can continue with the exercises. Thank you.